Now, many of you know what I have just done.
Black Sabbath is a very long game. Their biography points us to that. Every element of it can be used to tell us more about different aspects of Birmingham's history, which is one of immigration, innovation, idealisation and recreation. I have done quite a few things. So this is a batch of scripts and screenplays. A keen guitarist. This year I've decided that I'm going to become a teacher.
Remember, you could repeat the first verse as the third verse.
Let's try one. Not that one. Don't meet your heroes, walk in their footsteps. This is the living room of a terrace house in North Birmingham that's very similar to the living rooms of the terrace houses in North Birmingham where the original members of Black Sabbath grew up. Black Sabbath is integral to the story of this city, Birmingham. Being a music fan all my life, that became of great interest to me a few years ago, and I've explored that as far as I can. I decided that one of the best ways for me to communicate this information to people was the Crossroads of Sabbath walking tour.
They're cutting down a tree over there. Are they cutting that tree down? There's some tree work going on over there, which I know a little bit about, having worked as a tree surgeon. Well, with a tree surgeon. Anyway.
My research method has been very much on the ground. Every day, to and from work, with a notebook and a pen, and a very open mind.
What we are standing outside is the IMI, Imperial Metal Industries. I was in Ozzy Osbourne's class and we used to walk past your gates every morning on the way to school. And when I asked them about it further, I was intrigued that they used to test the ammunition behind these gates. This guy used to hear them testing. And in the schoolyard, you used to be able to hear them testing rifle shots. And it went like this. Which is the cadence of war pigs. That might be right, it might be wrong.
I've always known that Ozzy Osbourne lived at 14 Lodge Road. I wasn't going to make too much of a play of those very obvious places, and anything that I found that was a little quirky and a little outside the box that was able to tell us a slightly different story of the population more generally, then I would include those.
This area that we're in now, people view it as a Tesco car park. It is a Tesco car park, but it was Witton Wharf. Well, it was a railway hub. The train line is still there, although I don't think that no train has passed since we've been here.
We did when we got
here. Right, okay.
People don't understand the levels that I've gone to in order to do this work. I find it interesting when people tell me things about Black Sabbath as if I don't know them.
Now, I think that the Black Sabbath, there's numerous high points in the career, and there's numerous low points as well. And one of the high points is undoubtedly this moment. I'm not going to chuck my coat anywhere. It cost a lot of money. Now, many of you know what I have just done. I have done a historical reenactment of the point at the California Jam where Ozzy already knew what he knew, tried to communicate it to 250,000 Californians. Why are we standing opposite a wonderful sounding piece of metal? Because that hasn't always been there. Go back to Black Sabbath, who are they? Anyway, point is, this is what they saw every day, you know, as they walked from their homes to their school. They would have seen other people working their asses off to survive, to not drown. And no one wants to drown.
Much has been made of the influence of the industry in Birmingham on the character of Black Sabbath's music. I'm really drawn to the what I call the original lineup sculpture because it's on the way to Aldi.
These four or five buildings, or six buildings even, represent to me the magic of when four blokes go into a room together. Because when you hit it, and you know you've hit it, and you've all started in the right time, and you finish at the right time, and it works, it can be one of the most incredible things that's ever happened to a young man. This is this city's saving grace. It's Tony, Bill, the Bard, Ozzy, and the fifth thing is a manager. A manager worth his salt, worth his weight in gold. That's probably why they were able to elevate themselves through the communication device signified in the middle there by the BT Tower. The line up, the original line up.
There is something about the way that Tony Iommi was able to perfect his guitar sound, his guitar tone, that very much speaks to something within the human psyche. It enables human beings to alleviate some of the stresses of being a human. I think a song is a very good way of expressing something about yourself and about your situation that can really help with it. This year, I've decided that I'm going to try and become a teacher. I've been teaching Neville at the Garden Centre how to write a song.
Hi, Neville.
Hi. Hi, Rob.
So you remember it was four verses?
I do, yeah.
The shit list goes like this. The shit list goes like this.
Do you get the drift?
Yeah. So all songs, obviously, are...
different.
Obviously.
Do you remember, you could repeat the first verse as the third verse. That works. We all know someone who did that.
Okay. Go on. Don't recognise that.
Maybe one day in the future when he needs to write a song, he'll remember those lessons and... he'll be able to do it.
See ya.
Okay, Rob. Thank you. See you
again. I met Rob while I was trying to resuscitate a tree. The concert that I did was me playing the flute to the tree, and Rob was the only audience member. He was the only person crazy enough to come and see me do my crazy shit.
There is no doubt that without Black Sabbath, the heavy metal universe would be different.
They are
universally acknowledged as the originators of heavy metal. Now, I don't quite agree with that in that I believe the originator of heavy metal was a marketing person who grouped a load of bands together as a genre in order that they could put them in a certain section in the record shop.
That's good.
The best song is the song that you write, and that you, it belongs to you and can never belong to anyone else.
Let's touch more volumes.
Beautiful.
Goes like this.
Music is the companion of joy, the medicine of sorrow, the engine of identity, and the fuel of tomorrow.
It's called the hit list. Everyone is a hit. Even though they are sometimes a bit lacking, the hit list.